Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Pedro Cataldi. I want to thank the opportunity to present my work here in the 10th Friends of Friends meeting. I'm going to present my most recent work published in MNRS in collaboration with Susana Pedrosa, Patricia Teixeira, and Maria Celeste Artale about the different ways and mechanisms that variants modify the dark matter halo shape. So let me just back up a little bit and explain the motivation that aims us in the way to investigate this kind of effects in dark matter halo structures. First, the accurate determination of their properties in the presence of baryons have been a crucial task in the study of galaxy formation, even though many problems remain to be fully understood, such as cosmic dark problems or the missing satellite problem within the standard cosmological model. Second, the inflow of baryons within the central region of galaxies modify their internal structures and feedback processes such as supernova, HGN, or stellar formations contributes to regulate their condensation. Third, it has been previously shown that the baryons contribute to spherically-lighted dark matter halos becoming less triaxial in their presence. More recently, it has been found that when baryons are included, dark matter particle orbits, for instance, go mainly from box to tube types. Last but not least, we want to point out that there are strong numerical predictors for the shape of dark matter halos, but they are poorly constrained by current observational data. Most of these constraints of the Milky Way halo shape use the effects of Sagittarius stellar stream. So for this study, we analyzed two simulations performing with different versions of gadget code. First, the Eagle simulation with their main features. We used the Eagle sim of 100 megaparsec size box and with similar mass resolution as the Phoenix suite, but with much better statistics. Second, the Phoenix suite simulation with their main characteristic shown in the slide. Phoenix consists of a 14 megaparsec size box with this many particles and this mass resolution. We compare both runs with its dark matter-only counterpart. We are selecting objects resolved with more than 10,000 baryonic particles within their optical radius. For Eagle, this shields 1,700 galaxies, and for Phoenix, a subsample of 38 galaxies. Each object has a corresponding dark matter-only counterpart in order to perform a comparative study of baryonic effects. So let's do a refresh of some concepts. For the contraction and expansion studies, we will be analyzing the ratio between the dark matter masses measured at three different radii in the hydro compared to dark matter-only runs. We also will be analyzing the galaxy compactness factor percentage, an amount defined as the ratio between the half mass radius, typically the radius of the galaxy, and the virial radius. And a term introduced by Alam et al. 2002 for a robust measuring of contraction and expansion. This is the density of the halfway up radius, the typical region where conflicts between predicted and observed dark matter halo density are more severe. For halo shape, our main interest is to dig into the interdependence of halo shape and galaxy morphology. For this, we diagonalize the shape tensor, where A, B, and C are the major, intermediate, and minor axes, and define the quantities Q, intermediate to major axis, S, minor to major axis, and the triaxiality D defined as this. Finally, the velocity anisotropy beta is defined as we showed here. Here we show the typical relation between the shape parameters and the resulting halo morphologies. So now let's go with some results. In this figure, we show the dark matter mass ratio as a function of a stellar to halo mass, and the points are colored by the galaxy compactness factor percentage at 5, 10, and 20% of the virial radius. Our results show that in Phoenix halos only contract, while for the Eagle halos can contract or expand in hydro compared to dark matter only simulation. The expansion of Eagle halos in the central regions has been thoroughly analyzed by Schaller et al. 2015, and is the result of a more effective stellar feedback and a greater loss of variance, while the contraction is claimed to be the result of an increase of potential weld. Regarding the color in the figure, in the most inner region within 5% of the Villa radius, halos hosting more compact galaxies tend to be more contracted, as can be seen in the top panels. Blue dots and red and yellow dots on bottom. When these ratios are measured at 10 or 20% of the Villa radius in the middle or the below panel, this trend gradually disappears. So now, yes, with the next slide, we are showing in this figure the halo mass contraction and expansion as a function of the halfway up radius in the top panel and versus the stellar to halo mass ratio in the bottom panel. Again, the points are colored by the galaxy compactness percentage factor. The change of the dark matter contraction in the inner regions can be also quantified through the contraction expansion parameter delta. We can see that halos that contract have more compact galaxies, blue dots, and shorter halfway up radius. The halos also expand for extended galaxies. This is the yellow or red dots. The compactness of galaxies appear as a key parameter to trace the degree of contraction of the dark matter halos. We also inspect the shape parameters of the halos in relation with the measuring radius in the inner regions, these two total fractions and the stellar mass of the hosted galaxies. So in this figure, we are showing the shape parameters, Q, S, and the triaxiality median values versus the radius for Eagle in solid lines and for Phoenix halos in dashed lines. Here, the light green lines are the hydro simulations and the black lines the dark matter only counterpart. The shaded areas represent the 25 and the 75 quartiles, and halos have been divided in three subsamples according to the morphology of the hosted galaxies, here represented in these two total fractions. Each panel includes the relative change between hydro and dark matter only halos. It can be seen that near the Villa radius, the effects of baryon on triaxiality diminish, recovering the triaxiality typical of the outer regions. But an important feature is that the signal appear to maximize around the 20% of the Villa radius, independently of the predominance of the stellar disk. For Phoenix halos example, we do not detect a clear strengthening of the signal for a particular radius, here in dashed lines. In the next figure, we are showing the 2D histogram comparing the shape parameters for hydro in the y-axis and dark matter only halos in the x-axis for the Eagle simulation at 4 selected radius. In the outer regions, the shape parameters are almost identical for both runs, as changing halo shapes are less significant near the Villa radius. But in the inner region, the larger deviation from identity is detected at the 20% of the Villa radius. This is important because the region that maximizes the effects of the shape change is shifted with respect to the most inner regions, where halos typically contract more. We also explore the mass dependence of the shape parameters. In this figure, we show the shape parameters as a function of the medial mass. We can see that more massive halos tend to be more triaxial. But when we consider the dependence on stellar to halo mass, this trend inverts as described by previous authors. To better visualize this trend, in the next figure, we show B2A versus C2B ratio of trade for 2019, but for the Dharma Trade halo shape. In this plane, halos close to the top right corner are more spherical. There is a rather statistical weak trend for more prolate halo shapes to be found hosting more massive stellar objects. We also show here some observational constraints for the dark matter halo shape of the Milky Way at different radii. The most interesting result we found was when we analyzed the shape dependence with morphology. In the next figure, we show the same plane, but with bins of galaxy morphology for hydrohalos in the left panels and for their dark matter only counterpart in the right panel. There is a trend at the 20% of the viral radius to be globally more oblate for higher these two total fractions for hydro, and also interestingly for the dark matter only counterpart. So our results suggest that the combination of dark matter only halo masses could be used as an input in semi-analytical models to predict the probability that the halo hosts a galaxy with a specific morphology. Dark matter halo shape parameters measured at the 20% of the viral radius in the hydro runs as a function of these two total fractions is showing in this figure. Halos become more spherical and less triaxial for higher these two total fractions, more spherical and less triaxials. But when this relation is normalized by dark matter only simulation and halos, this correlation strongly weakens. This supports the fact that these galaxies form preferentially in more spherical dark matter halos. Finally, we analyze the dark matter velocity structures. In this figure, we show beta as a function of radius, and dotted lines indicate the median of the distribution in the case of the Phoenix halos, and solid lines in the case of the Eagle halos in the right panels. Beta is divided with these fractions bins. Halos hosting almost bunched galaxies here in the black lines present a higher value of velocity anisotropy at central radii. When the dark matter only is expected, this shows a slight trend in the same sense, albeit weaker. So for the last figure, we show the relative change of the anisotropy with respect to the median relation as a function of radius for Phoenix and for Eagle halos. Shadow areas here enclose the errors computed using a bootstrap sample. Panel B and D that represent the dark matter only halos show a slight trend in the same sense, a bit weaker than intrinsic behavior, indicating that halos host a more important stellar disk structures tend to have a distinctive, slightly less isotropic dark matter velocity pattern. So for the conclusions, the impact of baryons on the dark matter halo structure maximizes when it's measured within the 20% of the viral radius. More compact galaxies are located in more contracted dark matter halos. Halos hosting baryons become less triaxial in agreement with previous studies. Halos hosting galaxies with higher these two total fraction are rounder and less triaxial with greater velocity anisotropies. However, this trend is already present in the dark matter only halos. This indicates a remarkable result, because could potentially provide a statistical predictor of the morphology that the galaxy would have if it were to form in a halo of a given shape. Thanks. Any questions?